inverse multiplication, and that's the expression. The expression given to you is A into B plus C, the possible expression. Again, the solution part. You can check. The first table structure is same, as well as first row is also same, only the expression has been changed now. A into B plus C. You are ready to convert now. Integer expression A into B plus C to postman expression. Let us do it. The first step is we write the integer expression given to us as it is into the first column. Now in the next step, we will scan the first symbol. If you scan the first symbol, remaining string in the first column would be into B plus C. A goes into the remark column. The last two columns are empty. So this is your second step. In the third step, we will take the decision at remark column. We'll check whether it is operator or operand. And we found that it is operand, we have to put it into postman expression. So as soon as you shift A into last column, remaining string becomes B plus C, and multiplication goes into the remark column, in the scan symbol column. And A goes directly into the postman. Now, again, we look at the remark column. We check what is there. There is the remark column. If it is operand, put it into the last column. If it is operator, put it into the operator stack. And before putting any operator into the operator stack, we always check the operator position. Right now, my operator stack is empty, so I can directly put multiplication into the operator stack. So as soon as you shift multiplication into the operator stack, the symbol B gets copied into remark column, and the remaining string in the first column would be plus. Here B is there. Then multiplication goes into the operator stack, and in the last column we have A. Now, again we take the decision, take the remark column and take the decision. Check whether it is operator or operand. If it is operand, directly put it into the last column. B is operand, it goes directly into the last column. So as soon as you shift B into the last column, the plus operator gets copied into remark column. Plus comes into the remark column, B goes into last column, that is after A, it becomes AB. Now, again we check the remark column, it is operator. If it is operator, we have to put that operator into the operator stack. But right now, before putting this operator into the operator stack, we have to check the operator precedence. Can we put plus over multiplication? It means lower precedence operator is plus, high precedence operator in the stack is multiplication. You can easily put higher precedence operator over lower precedence operator, but you cannot put a lower precedence operator on high precedence operator in the stack. You can check what is the topmost element of the stack is multiplication. I cannot put plus over multiplication. Then in this situation, what to do? If this is the situation, you have to pop out the higher precedence operator than this coming operator. Whatever may be, it may be two, three operators also, or one operator also. Right now there is only one operator, higher precedence operator. Whatever may be the higher precedence operator are there in on top of the stack. Or in the stack, you have to remove those operators from the stack and put those operators into the last column, and then move this plus on top of the stack. So in the next step, we are going to do that. C remains as it is in the first column. Here you can see plus goes into the stack and multiplication goes in the last. So it means we perform pop operation first, that is multiplication goes into the last column, and then we shifted plus into the stack. First multiplication goes out of the stack, and then plus come into the stack. In the last step, the column becomes empty. It gets copied into the remark column. Here we have plus. In the last column, we have AB. Stop. Again, we check the remark column and we found that it is operand. It goes directly into the last column. We have plus remain into the first column, the third column is the other side. In the last column, we have AB into and then now C. Now the last column come into the picture. If there are no symbols for scanning in the first column, it is empty. If it is empty and if your stock stack is not empty, then what to do? Pop out all the elements from the stack to the last column. So this becomes empty. Next is also empty. This also becomes empty. And in the last one we have AB into C and now plus. So this is the output of the given expression. Then take the output of the given expression. Complete expression AB. A into B plus C. This exact first of the expression is AB into C plus. In this example, we come across a situation where the operator coming is having lower precedence and on top of the stack we have higher precedence operator. In that case, we cannot put a lower precedence operator over higher precedence operator. To avoid clash, we have to first shift all higher precedence operator from the stack to the posterior expression and then move the lower precedence operator into the stack. Okay. So this is the second example of conversion of infinite expression.